Hi, Liftoff. I'm Tim Baxter.
And I'm Jack Lee, and we made Richest of Life. We'd wanted to make a film for quite a long time. We'd kind of been making a lot of corporate, and we'd made some TV shows, and we wanted to make something that had a lot of creative freedom. Tim's background is as a DOP, and mine was more of a storyteller. So we wanted to find a project that combined the opportunity for great visuals and a great story. And when we met Marko, it all seemed to come together, really. So yeah, we ended up flying out to the Arctic and making a film about Arctic gold prospecting. When we were making Richest of Life, we were in the process of setting up a production company called 8 Engines, which 4 and a bit years later has grown. We produce a lot of different types of work, so we do marketing stuff, we've done a few TV shows, we do a bit of everything.
Yeah, and we're in the middle of starting pre-production on a really exciting project we're looking at once lockdown's all finished and over. Going to Indonesia and got a really exciting project there, so I'm looking forward to it.
4 years later, that's kind of the spiritual sequel to Richest of Life. So in terms of our experience with Liftoff, we had a great time. We went to the Manchester Liftoff Festival, which we were really happy to eventually win. And then we were invited to the Liftoff Season Awards at Pinewood, which was really cool. Yeah.
Yeah, it was fantastic going to Pinewood, meeting everyone there, seeing the other filmmakers. A great moment, great time, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Here's our film, Richest of Life. I hope you enjoy it as much as we did making it.
Yeah, have fun.
I wanna be the man who finds biggest nugget in the world. And I wanna keep it and never sell it. And maybe after 1 billion years, some other guys picking that gold.
My name is Marko, and I have been a gold digger over 30 years. Gold has made me what I am. My father was the man who takes me first time to the gold fields.
Over 30 years ago, I was 6 or 7 years old.
After our visits, I told my dad I will never be back because it was so rough. But somehow, every spring when father asked me, hey, Marko, are we going to be prospect? I said, yes.
I work for the Nokia mobile phones almost 20 years.
First it was good because we needed money and it was okay. But then I just tired to be there.
In last years they were so bad. I was in therapy. And I had manic depression. It was so mixed up with my body and with my mind. It was a disaster for me. It was so pointless to be in therapy, to eat drugs so you can do your work. It was terrible. And I didn't like that life at all.
Every morning, we must be able to watch ourselves in the mirror. We need to have that feeling that I'm doing the right thing. Just had to it.
Because I'm dying.
I had stuff like sofas and chairs and tables and that kind of stuff. And I was starting to think, what can I take with me? Not this all. So it was much easier to put it together and burn it. Little gasoline and oh, that feels good. Fire gives a new born, rising from the ashes. It cleans. Next morning I wake up and I pack my things, what I need and what I can take in my car. Guitars, cameras and clothes. And then I leave everything. I leave my family, my child and my wife. Just run away. It was only choice for me to be alive. Tungavara is a place for the dreams, and they can come true. Cold is very magical, and there's lots of stories between a man and cold. Cold comes from supernova, hundreds and billions of years ago. Some star explodes and it gives those minerals to the sky. It has been hundreds of thousands of years in the soil. It has been waiting for me, and then I found it. I pick it up, and it's mine. There must be very big nuggets. It just waits. Maybe me, maybe some other guy will find it, but it just waits there. Maybe another 100,000 years. That's why Tankavara and whole Lapland are so important and mystical places to dream hunters. Gold is more valuable than money. Money you can spend, you can buy things. But when you have a goal, you really don't want to sell it. You want to keep it. Life is rich and wonderful when you get it right. All of us, we have our own right feeling. And this is mine. Gold diggers always lied for themselves. They are making things bigger in their minds. This is like an illusion. No one really lives with the gold digging by the shovel. No, it's impossible. But that's the gold fever. You're cheating yourself. Gold fever is madness. You really cannot have it enough. You want more and more, you forget yourself. You don't mind when you're tired. You just continue and continue and continue till you collapse. It's like a fighting between me and greed. Winter is long, too long, and it's very hard to find gold. It's much harder work than the summertime. But knowing like areas where might be gold, you might find it in the wintertime too, by the smelting of the snow, and search it with a metal detector. It's possible, but you really need to know where to search. Nature and gold digging, it goes hand by hand. If you take a challenge with the nature, you will lose. It gives us everything. It takes care of us. I just love it to be in the wild. If someone is so proud about himself, if he can stare to the sky and stars, moon, northern lights, and yell, "Hey, I'm important," do you feel? feel very important at that moment. No, that feeling, I am nothing, it's most important to get.
In Finland, we have this word sielunmaisema. It's your soul site. I know this is my place. I belong here. It's just that yellow metal. And you see it in a gold pen. And it gives that wow, wow, wow. But it's not worth of anything. Just an experience. It's a rough world. Lots of misery and lost dreams and also hope.